Welcome back to another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies like me, and I'm going to show you how to do some real neat things today with Elementor. Now, if you're not familiar with Elementor, it's a very popular, very feature-rich page builder, and it just so happens to be free, although they do have a professional version of it, but everything I show you in this video is going to be done with the free version of it. But stay to the end of the video. I have a special promotion with the paid version if you're interested in that. So what I want to show you how to do is make some feature boxes today. So yesterday I did a review on this new service from StudioPress. You might have seen the video, maybe, maybe not. And there's some really nice design elements in this page. And one of the things StudioPress is known for is their keen eye for design. And when you take that and you pair it up with Elementor, you can essentially create a lot of the same design elements you see that they're doing, but you can have it in your Elementor-based website because of the features that Elementor has. So one of the things, actually I've seen several things on here that I want to make videos on. I want to make a video on the text just coming off the page here, how to do that, do a box like this with Elementor. But I wanted to start it with how to make this. And I really liked this kind of a feature box that kind of is pulled off the page like this. I thought this would be very nice for lots of different reasons where you might be have an image on one side and then you have a bit of text to go with it and then it's lifted up off the page just a little bit. So I was playing around today with Elementor and this is what I came up with. I have two different examples of that I'm going to show you how I did it in this video so that you can do it as well. And here's the first example right here. You can see it's very close to what they have going on. Obviously, I'm not using their font. And I think my blur is a little tighter than their blur. So you can see here, there is a blur. It is lifted a little bit, but it's a little bit more subtle. And we can tweak this to be however we want it with Elementor. And plus, with StudioPress, they had some kind of a background element there. But anyways, this is what I came up with, this example here. I thought it'd be great for any kind of service where you put an image there and some text to go along with it. And then here's another example, but using the gradient feature that was recently added to Elementor. This is such a powerful feature. In fact, when you're on the StudioPress website, you do see them using gradients right here at the top. You can see how it's a darker blue here and a lighter blue here. Well, now you could do that same exact thing with Elementor. So let's go ahead and just get into the editor so I can show you how I did this. So I'm going to click on Edit with Elementor so we can get into the page builder itself. One of my favorite things about this page builder, you make a change, it shows instantly on the side here. So essentially what this is a column. And for the column, I have a background image and I'm using that gradient feature to use to get this diagonal sharp line here with a different color. And then these are two columns. So this is a column with just two text elements and I did push it over a little bit in the margin. So let's take a look at these settings for the column. So I'm going to click on column right here. And what I did is I chose a background image. Now this could be any background image. I could even change it in this video. Let's see what I can come up with, just what's there. You definitely want a wide image that is going to stretch the whole width of that column there. So let's take a look and see what I've got. I actually don't have many options. There's the one that I used. If I use this, it's going to show primarily a plate there, an empty plate. You can see that there. It doesn't look good. So I'm going to have to go back with my image. So anyways, we've got an image. And let's go ahead and collapse this background and border section because we're going to use this background overlay section. So today they released a new feature that allows you to add gradients to your backgrounds. And it could be just the gradient instead of an image, or you could put an image in, you can overlay the gradient. And the same thing goes for videos. You can have a video playing in the background and then you can overlay a gradient on top of it. But with these gradient controls, you can get this sharp line and you can have it be at any angle that you want. So where I have background and overlay, you now have this new option here that says gradient. And with gradients, you choose two colors. And then with the gradient settings, it blends those two colors together. So for the first color right here, you can click on this box. I just chose white, but then I made it completely transparent with this slider here. You could choose any color. It doesn't really matter because you're going to have this transparency slider all the way down so that image is totally transparent. However, if you did want a little bit of a different color on this side to make it pop, you could certainly do that and choose a color like this and go over it with it. It's completely up to you, but I wanted just the image. And so you could choose any color and then have the transparency side all the way down to the bottom so the color isn't shown. So let's remove that. And then for the second color, I chose white, obviously, and it's white, but you could choose any color you wanted. That made sense for you, but I chose white and there's no transparency. However, if I wanted to, I could do this and kind of blend in the image from the background, but that's not the look I was after. And then we have this location, and this is where the blending begins. So I wanted it right in the middle, so I put this at 50%. But if you wanted it over a little more this way or that way, you could do whatever you wanted. I wanted 50. Now this is the location of the other color going the other direction, and I left this at 0 to get that sharp line across. So there's two different types of gradients. This is linear and this is radial. I'm not going for the radial look, so I'm going to go back to linear like that. And then for the angle, a 90 degree angle is straight up and down. So I have it set to 100, but if I had 90, you could see it's a straight up and down arrow like that. But I wanted a little style to it, so that's why I put 100. And you can make that be whatever you want. You can see as you move this slider, it starts to move around. So I wanted that to be just at 100, and you can have it be whatever you want. And if I was looking at here, eyeballing this, I would say they are pretty close to 100 as well. It looks pretty much the same thing. And then here is opacity, and this is the translucentness of the entire blended gradient color. And I have it at 1, which means there's no transparency, but this is another way where I could have added some transparency to it. So this is a really good way to highlight something on your website that you want to highlight. So if it was a restaurant, you can have it be one of your main categories of food. Or if it is a service, it could be about a particular service that you offer. If it's about carpet cleaning, you can have a picture of a guy cleaning a carpet, and then you could talk about on the side just a little bit about what that image is showing to pull it all together. And lastly, for the entire column, what I did is I added a shadow, a box shadow, and that's going to be found here. When I scroll down, here's the box shadow option. I enabled it and I set it to 20, but we might want to blur that out just a little bit more and spread it out so it's a little more subtle. So you see, as I go up to say 50, the blur is a lot more subtle. When you're here, the blur is a lot more subtle, but it's definitely there. And lastly, there is a very thin border here. So I put a thin border around the entire column, and that was right here under border type. I did solid and I made it the color white, and I had it ever so subtly around just like that. So this is how I accomplish this. And I think this would be really good on any website to integrate some effects like this. Now, you don't want to overdo it. You don't want a million boxes like this with the shadow and all that kind of stuff, but you could definitely use this a lot on a particular website. Now, this is using a color gradient that I'm actually blending in two colors together. So let's take a look at that really quick. So I have that same background image. Let me collapse that. Now, unlike the first example up here, where I was using the location for the first color, This time I have that set to zero and I'm using the location for the second color, which is this blue. And with the blue, there's a slight transparency there. So when you click on the blue color, you can see I just have it ever so slightly. So this is with no transparency and this is with just a slight transparency down, just like that. Now, what I'm doing here is I'm using the location slider for the second color. So if I was to go all the way across, it would make it all that blue color, but I'm playing around with it right here, and I think I was at about 50 or something like that. I just wanted there to be more of a solid color behind the text, and that's how I was playing with it that way. And I have a slightly different angle. I had it set to 100 in the prior example, but you can see as I do it, it starts to rotate around. My goal here was to have the color be more solid underneath the text so the text would be easier to read. Now, if I wanted to do that solid line bit that you saw earlier, I could just go like this and see if I made the same number as on up here as I have down there, you would see that it would be perfectly solid like it is right now. It's just perfectly solid. But I wanted it to kind of spread and blur out and just ease into the image like you see. Now, if I wanted this to be a different color, I could easily do that as well. I could go with something maybe vibrant like this and go something like that. Maybe lighten it up. Maybe have it be just a little different like that. And you can see there I have this transparency going on that way. So these are just two ways where you can add a bit more flair to your website to give it those nice design touches that will really make it stand out and take the typical text and images and mix them together and make them look a lot better than other websites would have. And I think you should definitely experiment with having a section like this. Like I said, I just got it from this website right here. I was inspired and I recreated it. And that's the best thing about Elementor is you can really see anything and just about anything you can recreate with Elementor. They are really giving you those design tools. Now, if you're not familiar with the pro version of Elementor, it adds a lot of more features to Elementor. And these are things that you normally have to buy additional plugins to get these features, like forms. The pro version has a full form builder in it, and it's the most powerful visual form builder I've ever seen. You can create sliders, you can create pricing tables. There's a whole laundry list of things that you could do with the pro version. However, everything I showed you in this video, you don't need the pro version for. I have a special promotion. If you do purchase the pro version through my link, I'm going to give you access to a course that I put together called Elementor Essentials. It's ready for you right now on my website. If you liked some of the tips that I showed you in this video, you're going to learn a lot more in this course. And it's more than just a course on Elementor. It's actually a course on building websites, and I just so happen to use Elementor as the tool to build websites in this course. It's a very powerful course, and if you're building a website for yourself, it's definitely worth it. You could purchase the course for $97, or if you purchase Elementor through my link, which you can find in the pinned comment section, and then contact me, send me a copy of your receipt. I'll verify you did purchase it through my link, and I will get you enrolled in this course for free. Because you made it to the end of the video, I have a free gift for you. But before I talk about that, I want to ask you to do something for me. If you could give this video a thumbs up down below, that would really help me out. If you're not subscribed to the channel, go ahead and click on that subscribe button and become a subscriber and support this channel. And if you'd like YouTube to notify you when I upload new videos, there's a little bell next to that subscribe button. You can click on that and set that up as well. If you have any questions or a comment about this video, I'd love to answer it. There's a comment section down below. All you have to do is put in your question or comment. I respond to every single one. Hey, I made a course just for you, and it's called The 3 Steps to WordPress Success, and I want to give this to you. If you'd like to enroll in this course, there's a button right here off to the right. You can go ahead and click on that, enroll as a student, and that's just my way of saying thank you for supporting me and making it to the end of this video. I make them just for you. Thank you.